हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द क्लास। लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट लिबर्टी एंड द सेफ गार्ड ऑफ लिबर्टी। व्हाट आर द पॉइंट्स, हाउ वी कैन एबल टू प्रोटेक्ट द लिबर्टी एंड व्हाट आर द सेफ गार्ड्स ऑफ द लिबर्टी। सो वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग द सेम टॉपिक। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट दिस कॉन्सेप्ट, डेमोक्रेसी एंड रूल ऑफ लॉ। ओके, सो इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट हाउ द डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री, how the democratic countries are very important to safeguard the republic rule, liberty, how the democratic countries are important to safeguard the liberty, and rule of law also we have discussed. Now in this concept we are discussing about fundamental rights. Students, fundamental rights also plays a very important role to protect the liberty, okay, freedom. So this is one point. So today we'll discuss about this point, but before going, already you know the meanings as well as definition, just we'll go with the introduction point. The concept of liberty is very important subject in the political science. So the concept of liberty is very significant in political science. Okay, if you see the concept of liberty, man cannot be personality, and this is inspirations for the concept of liberty is inspirations for millions of people. Okay, the liberty concept is inspirations for millions of people, and this liberty is quite distinctive qualities when compared to man. When man is comparing with any other living organisms or the life, liberty is quite different quality. Okay, and we have seen that individuals cannot enjoy the liberty, isolations are in separate form. Okay, so we have discussed they are nearly in both the sense we have discussed already. Meaning of liberty already we have discussed in the last class. The word liberty is originated from the Latin word liber, which means to set free from all type of restriction. Okay. Definition also we have studied in the last class. Now directly we are going to the main points, which is fundamental rights. In the last class we have discussed about the safeguards of liberty. One is democracy and rule of law. In this class we will discuss about fundamental rights. Children, fundamental rights place, fundamental rights is authentic. Authentic is nothing but, this is not a copy, it is a genuine right. Okay, fundamental right is not a copy, but this is a genuine right which is given to the citizen. And these fundamental rights are guaranteed to all the citizens of the country, guarantee and compulsory, all the citizens will have fundamental rights. We have already know that fundamental rights are very important. If any citizens are not getting the fundamental rights, they can take the support of court of law also. Whenever the citizens are unable to get the fundamental rights, so they can go for the court of law. These fundamental rights plays very important role for providing liberty to the people. Okay, rights are nothing but freedom. Whenever the fundamental rights means, these rights are giving to the citizens so that they should enjoy the freedom, liberty. So fundamental rights are providing liberty to the people by providing various rights. Fundamental have different rights. So these rights will provide liberty and the freedom to the citizens. And the fundamental rights is one of the powerful instrument. Okay, these rights are one of the powerful instrument. Okay, to provide freedom to the citizens. When you are seeing the constitution with the fundamental rights, Britain and British constitutions. Students, whenever the constitution, Indian constitution is rigid constitution. There are many constitutions which are rigid. What is meant by rigid? Whenever to change the constitution, if you are adopting a difficult process, okay, there are some constitutions which can't be changed easily. Okay, some constitutions like fundamental rights cannot be changed easily. Okay, there are many concepts in the constitution, we can't change them. And if we wanted to change also, we have to adopt a difficult process. That is called as rigid constitution. Okay, opposite of rigid, flexible. Flexible constitution. So opposite of rigid is flexible. Now I'll go forward. Rigid is in the sense very difficult constitution. If you can't change the process easily, if you wanted to change the constitution, we have to adopt a very difficult process. Now I'll go forward. Now this written constitution is very important. And this written constitutions will safeguard the individual liberty. Okay, written constitution, we can find that constitution with fundamental rights have rigid constitution, and they are very important. And they are very important, why? Because they will protect the individual liberty. Okay, freedom, they will protect the freedom of the people. Next question is, These rigid constitutions will incorporate various freedom. Incorporate is nothing but something which is as a part of whole. Okay, so this written constitutions incorporates various freedom. So whatever the rights which are incorporated in the written constitutions will provide various freedom to the citizens. And this written constitution act as a custodian. What is meant by custodian? Something that guards you, something which are protector or which act as a guard, that is called as custodians. So written constitutions or rigid constitution act as a guard, and they will protect the people's, what they will protect the people's right as well as liberty. So this written constitution act as a custodians, and they will protect the rights of the people, they will protect the liberty of the people. Now the written constitution, sometime they will demarcates. Demarcates are nothing but setting a boundaries or limits. Anything which has a which can sets a boundary and limit, that is called as demarcates. Okay, the written constitutions will demarcate the spheres of government activity also. So government also have to perform their activities in the limit. Okay, so whatever the written constitutions are there, they are providing freedom to the people, because first thing is this written constitution is very important. Why? Because they are providing the individual freedom. Second thing is this written constitution is very important because they are incorporating among various freedoms. Written constitution act as a custodian for the rights as well as liberty of the citizens. This written constitution act as a protector. This written constitution act as a custodian. So they are protecting the rights as well as liberty of the people. And sometime they will set a limit of government activity also. Written constitution is setting an limit for the government activity. So even though the government which are in power, they have to perform the activities up to the certain limit. And who is pronouncing the limit is written constitutions. So they will demarcate the spheres of government activity. Okay, that is one point. Next come to the point. So this written constitution, if you see, they will mention the various measures such as people's freedom, like infringed and confiscated. People's freedom cannot be infringed and confiscated. Infringed is nothing but fail to obey. Okay, so these written constitutions will provide various measures so that the people's freedoms must not be infringed and the people's freedom should not be confiscated. Confiscated means taken away. If somebody have taken away forcefully, that is called as confiscated. So written constitutions has made various provisions so that the individual should enjoy the freedom, and the freedom must not be infringed, or the freedom which not be confiscated by any people. Okay, so written constitution has imposed some restraints, means restriction. So written constitution has imposed various types of restrictions upon the political party so that they cannot amend the constitution further according to their interest. Okay, amend is nothing but changes. So written constitution has adopted some process, complicated process, so that if the political parties wanted to change the constitution, they can't change easily. For example, fundamental rights. Fundamental rights cannot be changed. Fundamental rights cannot be changed. Okay, even though there are some rights which wanted to change, but to adopt or to amend the changes, they have to adopt some difficult process. So written constitution is making a restriction upon political party. So written constitution is making a restriction. What type of restriction? So that the political parties cannot change their constitution by their own. Okay, the political parties cannot amend the constitution further according to their interest. Okay, this is also one point. So written constitution playing a very important role, due to which they are protecting the rights as well as liberty of the people. Okay, what we have discussed, once again we'll go forward. Now in this point we are discussing about the fundamental rights. So here we have discussed about fundamental rights, which is called authentic rights. Authentic rights are nothing but, this is not a copy, but this is a genuine right. Fundamental rights have guaranteed to all the citizens of the country. Fundamental rights plays very important role for providing freedom to the people, and the fundamental rights is one of the powerful instrument among all the rights. Fundamental rights is a powerful. When you are seeing in the fundamental rights, we have some constitutions like written and rigid constitution. Our constitution is a written constitution, we know, and there are some process where our constitution is a rigid constitution. rigid constitution means whenever if you wanted to change the constitution, it is very difficult, or the process to change the constitution have a complicated process. If you wanted to change the constitution, or if you wanted to amend the constitution, whenever if you are adopting a difficult process, so that is called as rigid constitution. Now our Indian written constitution is very important because they are protecting and they are safeguarding the individual liberty, and they are greatly incorporated for providing various freedoms. Okay, incorporate, what I said, what is meant by incorporate? Something as a part, as a whole. Okay, so this written constitution is incorporated and they are providing various freedom, and this written constitution act as a custodian of the people. The written constitution act as a custodian by providing the rights as well as liberty of the people, and this written constitution is setting, okay, they are demarcates the spheres of government activity. They are setting up some boundaries, okay, they are setting up some boundaries, they are setting up some limitations for the government activity by the written rigid constitution. These rigid constitutions have mentioned various provisions and measures so that the citizens' rights should not be infringed, or the citizens' rights should not be confiscated by any people. Okay, their rights will be protected. And next one, they have imposed various types of restrictions on political parties so that if these political parties wanted to amend the constitutions or to change the constitution according to their interest, they can't. Okay, so written constitutions has made various provisions so that they have made various restrictions also so that the political parties which are there, they can't change the constitutions for their will or for their interest. So they have imposed various types of restrictions on political party so that further the constitutions cannot be amended. So this is one point. So children, this is about the point and the topic which we are learning about the fundamental rights. Already in the previous point we have discussed what is the meaning and definition about the fundamental rights. We have discussed, okay, about liberty. Okay, this is a part. Okay, this is about one of the part, how to safeguard of liberty. Okay, fundamental rights. Previously we have completed democracy, rule of law, and now in this class we have completed about fundamental rights, in which we have discussed about rigid constitution. Okay, in the next class we will discuss with a new topic, children. We will meet you in the next class. Up to till now, thank you very much everybody.